can ask Josie Muley and Alistair Cameron to come forward for the Independent Māori Statutory Board, the proposed funding agreement for the 2018-2019 financial year. So we're considering an agreement that has been subject to review by our working party. Thank you to members of the working party, Councillors Cashmore, Clough, Collins and Hills, for the work that they've done. And I'll invite Alistair to speak to the paper, please.
Thank you,
Mr. And welcome Phil Wilson to the end of the table too.
Good morning, Mr. Mayor, councillors. Look, every year we're required by legislation to have a funding agreement in place with the Independent Māori Statutory Board. The proposed funding requested by the board this year is a relatively modest $47,000 increase from last year's budget. It's about 1.6%, so the total budget being sought by the IMSB is just over $3 million, as set out in the recommendations. Having had a review of the proposal, it seems reasonable in terms of their work program and compared to the funding they received last year. Happy to take questions.
Thank you very much, Alistair. I'll move the paper formally. Do I have a seconded for that? Deputy Mayor Cashmore, and questions to Alistair. Councillor Simpson.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm just inquiring over the extra budget for engagement of specialist Māori expertise for input into the Council's project plans work program. And I note that Council itself has $130,000 in our budget, which we've had unchanged for the previous 2 years. Can you please tell me, have we spent our $130,000 over the last 2 years?
My understanding is that we haven't, but that's budget that we carry in case that we need to do some work in response to something that the IMSB is doing.
So I suppose my question, therefore, is if we haven't spent our $130,000 over the last couple of years, why are we increasing engagement by $190,000?
I think we just need to be clear that we're increasing the IMSB's budget for their engagement work, but not councils. We're able to resource that internally. I think the increase in the IMSB's budget relates to changes in the Resource Management Act, where Mana Whenua can have a greater role in consenting processes and the engagement.
Okay, and you still think that we need to keep our $130,000 in the pot?
We have it there. We don't.
It's in the matter of a contingency.
Yeah. It's more of a, Mr. Wilson advises me, a contingency that's there to be used. I don't think it's a specific budget item that we, it's funding that we can draw upon if needed to respond to IMSB activity.
Okay, and if I make just one final clarification. So the $190,000 extra is really just to deal with resource management issues. Because it's a lot extra in the scheme.
It relates to the advent of potential mana whakahono agreements, which is a legal requirement. We must respond to mana whenua expressions of interest in forming a further and specific relationship with mana whenua entities around resource management. We've got the first of those expressions from an iwi entity now, and there will be more in the next period of time. This is what that money relates to.
And IMSB have to do that as opposed to council?
They're supporting mana whenua with the processes sitting behind it.
Okay.
Okay. Councillor Chris Darby.
Thank you, Mayor. The last time this came up, I asked a question about other payment and support, and at paragraph, I think it is 26, you refer to the service level agreement, which is, those numbers aren't listed here, but there is a further level of support, but I gather it's not actually considered as part of the funding agreement. And so in the future, are we likely to get that at the same time as the funding agreement review? Because I just think it's important to try and have a lens on everything. And my question, I think coming up about a year ago, was how do we give visibility to the property payments as well? Because I understand that is not identified as part of the funding agreement, if I'm correct. It's not part of the business as usual.
No, we council, separate to the funding we provide here, we meet the IMSB's rental costs and insurance, and we have agreements where we cover their telecommunication costs and the like. We will send that to all councillors as soon as it's been finalised to make it visible to you all. Look, ideally we would have had it here today, but we haven't finished working that agreement through yet, so we will make that available as soon as it's completed.
So the next, I guess my question is that it's good to have it all on one paper so that we could see the funding agreement costs and the work plan that cascades out of those costs, the property costs, the service level support, and if we could see that quantified, I think it is important to see it in one paper.
Noted, sorry, we'll make sure that happens next year. It's just been a timing issue this year.
Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Ndakukla.
Thank you. I agree, I'd like to see all the true cost of the organisation rather than separated out, because there's a lot of in-kind here or we're paying for things that we're not seeing. The other thing is I just want to go back to the that specialist expertise increase, because you talk about that here in terms of council engaging with Mana Whenua RMA, not IMSB. So that's my confusion as to when you have an RMA application, it's engagement with iwi, it's not engagement with IMSB. And that's where I'm confused about why they need money for that rather than more resourcing for our departments to help to support iwi. I mean, I just want to know whether that's actually their role. I thought they were more the role of making sure we are responsive to Māori rather than them doing it. That's what I'm not understanding.
I think they properly have a role supporting the Mana Whenua entities in that relationship with us, if that makes sense.
Is that a statutory role through you, Mr. Chair? Or is that something that's been designed along the way?
There are a number of statutory provisions related to the IMSB, including engagement with both Mana Whenua and Mā Tāwaka. There are also statutory provisions relating to the IMSB's input into our decision making and advice behind that, so it relates to that.
I'm just concerned that it might be seen as support. It's not keeping that hands-off approach to RMA applications where council's supporting certain parties that aren't part of council, but applicants don't get that, and I'm not advocating either one, but you know, there is a natural justice component of RMA or resource consent applications?
Yes. Sorry, I should be really clear here. This is not about input into specific consents or RMA decisions. This is about the relationship and the obligations that exist between a local authority and iwi, Mana Whenua, and they're supporting that them in that relationship.
Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Simpson, further question?
No, I think, Councillor Cooper and I were on the same page. It was just that clarity between the $190,000 extra for input into council projects, plans and work programs, vis-a-vis the RMA Māori provisions of an extra $30,000 for that. And the clarity for me, really, I'm still just not 100% sure is why we are spending $190,000 more for engagement of specialist Māori into our council projects and work programme. Can you just give me one more go, please?
Right.
Alistair.
Because we have to.
Yeah, look, I think the key word here is independent, in the Independent Māori Statutory Board. As part of the work programme that they've devised, they want and have a right to have their staff engaged in projects and work programmes at council. So it's more of a focus and emphasis of where their staff time will be utilised. I guess it's probably the best way to...
Yeah, it's more of an increase in last year.
Okay. Just a final question from me. We're legislatively bound to provide the support to the IMSB, so it's not a case of us choosing to or not choosing to. But the level of increase has each year has diminished from 2.4 2 years ago to 1.6 proposed for this year. How do you account? I mean, that's at about the level of, or a bit below the level of inflation. How do you account for the reduction in additional spending, the percentage increase?
It's probably just reaching a sort of a natural plateau as activities sort of settle down to a business as usual state. Probably the best way to characterise it. Phil, you might have some.
I think it also reflects the fact that the IMSB understands the financial position of the council and has been restrained in what it's sought in terms of funding increase, such that it's in line with what was provided as an inflation figure in the LTP.
Okay, thank you very much. We've finished questions. Is there any comment that anybody wants to make before I put the recommendations? We're approving the funding agreement, approving the level of variations no more than 50,000, and noting that this will be signed by the Mayor and Chief Executive and the Chair and Chief Executive of the IMSB. So I'll put that motion. All those in favour, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
To the contrary, no. I declare that carried. Thank you very much to our officers.